I think I was a little bit paralyzed for the first week, and I didn't realize the importance of being selected in the main competition in the Sarajevo Film Festival. But after that, I do realize the importance, and in the same time the responsibility of being selected. And then I had to work a lot for the film, and somehow by working I passed this kind of emotion. But again, the emotion started when I arrived here. Well, actually, the Tudor Voikan, the co-script writer, have heard this story, and it was an old story. And we started working on it. He had a first draft, wrote with another friend of ours who died, Catalin Kokrish, and started from that first draft of the story. We tried to develop it, to bring it to reality, to have some dramaturgical decision, like dropping out of the movie a lot of the story. And well, the fact that we had a reality base helped us a lot to understand the characters, to understand the relations between the main characters of the movie. Once Cristi Puiu told me if I could describe my film in one sentence, it was easier to write that sentence and not to make the film. But I would say that I wanted to speak about a woman who is ready to go till the end for her daughter, against anything, against any river coming over her, against any people opposing her. And I think this is the right description. It's about a character who is willing to go till the end to save the daughter. Well, when I was making the film, I tried not to push it, that's for sure. On the other hand, that's a very intimate proposal I made to myself. When I was starting to prepare the shooting, I was very determined to treat the character Mariana as a, I don't know, maybe like an Antigona or like a Medea or like a Greek tragedy character. A woman who does not cry, a woman made of stone, at least on the outside. And in the inside, very fragile and, you know, very emotional. But this is what we agreed together with Rodica, that the character will not cry, will fight and not cry. And if you remember in the movie, she has only one moment when she cried, when the doctor says the child is good. And we try to make this opposition, not to cry when the child is bad, but to cry when the child is feeling good. So during shooting, we were all very, very careful about not passing over and not making a melodrama or something. Then in the editing, we had the same concern, because after we saw the material, we had several shots or scene which could push the film over the limit, and we took them off. I think maybe this is a new Romanian cinema influence, let's say. After all, we are all part of it, and it's something that we are all learning by doing it, you know, not to push the limit. And I'm very glad that this is something that becomes the common base of the Romanian films. For me, at this moment, is the most important festival, that's for sure. On the other hand, I think it's such a big festival and it has such a big opportunities that I do think it's the biggest festival in the south, in this part of Europe. And maybe the most important thing for all the films is to be here, to be watched by people, and to reach the audience. And I think it's a very hard test for foreign films to go to a foreign audience, and which is not a compact audience. It's a mosaic audience made from people from all over the world coming to the festival. And maybe this is why I hope we will win this bet because we were talking about emotion. And actually, we have the advantage of that the emotion, it's an universal language, and everybody can feel, can feel the emotion. But I think it's, forgetting the emotion discussion, I think it's, in a pragmatic way, it's very important to be here because it's a very big festival and it can open a lot of gates for any movie present here. Well, I only had time last night after I arrived to see the city center a little bit, and I was absolutely amazed by how full of people the city is and how alive it is. And then the second one, it's how everything is mixed together in that city center. We saw a mosque, then we saw a Catholic cathedral, then a Jewish synagogue and an Orthodox church. And I think maybe this is a kind of definition for Sarajevo, you know, multiculturality. And this is something that amazed me. You know, parts of the city that looks like, I don't know, building like in Paris, and parts of the city which are oriental and Balkanics, and this is a very beautiful combination. Mm-hmm.